You know, we hear about the endocrine system and we may have these vague thoughts like, doesn't that have something to do with reproductive hormones? And yes, but the endocrine system is really so much more. It's actually a network of glands that produce, store, and actually balance a wide variety of hormones. And these hormones are vital to metabolism, growth, development, and really as a result, overall health. In fact, hormones are responsible for regulating almost every function in the body, timing the development of tissue and organs as you grow, controlling metabolism and your energy levels, managing insulin and sugar levels, communication between tissues that interact with each other, and yes, it also has a lot to do with reproduction as well. Now, your body always seeks homeostasis or balance, and your endocrine system is what provides that. Endocrine disruptors are chemicals or even mixtures of chemicals that can actually interfere with this normal hormone action. The production of certain hormones may increase and others may decrease, and affected cells may actually be told to die prematurely, or maybe they're not able to absorb essential nutrients. And all of this causes your body to rebalance in an unhealthy way and potentially triggering abnormal processes. For example, an overactive or underactive thyroid function or insulin resistance. Anytime tissue is developing, that's when sensitivity to endocrine disruption is actually at its highest. And for example, there's a very tight window for when specific organs are made in a developing fetus. A hormone disrupting chemical can change the way these processes happen. These changes may or may not be seen as birth defects, but they can induce irreversible damage that can lead to lifelong increased incidences of diseases or disorders. It's almost like a hidden marker that won't get played until later in life, oftentimes with unfortunate consequences. Now, the list of disorders linked to endocrine disruption is actually a long one. Reproductive abnormalities, including infertility and even early puberty. The impact on the function of the nervous and immune systems can be compromised. That can contribute to certain cancers like breast cancer, prostate, testicular cancer, other health problems, including metabolic issues, asthma, diabetes, obesity, heart disease, even neurological problems, including a wide variety of learning differences and disabilities, memory difficulties, Parkinson's. So the list goes on, and it's going to become even longer with more discoveries about the effects of these chemicals over time. Today, there are about 85,000 known chemicals in our environment, and more than 1,000 of these may be endocrine disruptors. And based on their probable endocrine interfering properties, the list of EDCs is filled with common chemicals that we've been widely using for years. Back in 2012, actually not long after I started at Norwex, the World Health Organization actually reported on the effects of endocrine disrupting chemicals. This report concluded that there is emerging evidence for adverse reproductive outcomes from exposure to EDCs, and there's also mounting, increasing evidence for effects of these chemicals on our bodies. Now, since that time, the evidence for damage from endocrine disruptors has continued to just grow. Research from a new book by Shauna Swan, who is an epidemiologist at Carl Icahn School of Medicine at Mount Sinai, actually found that sperm counts have dropped almost 60% since 1973. And following that same trajectory, those counts could potentially reach zero by 2045. Now, the author notes that chemicals to blame for this crisis are really all around us. They're in the plastic containers and food wrappings we have. They're in waterproof clothes, in our fragrances, even fragrances that are in cleaning products, that are in our soaps, our shampoos, even our electronics and carpeting that we have in our homes. So any effort to reduce these exposures to harmful EDCs will make a difference. And that's what Norwex products do every single day. So let's continue to be a voice for the dangers of these harmful chemicals that may be in our homes, because future generations may depend on it.